The Adjustments Inspector, introduced in Corel PHOTO-PAINT 2021, provides a range of non-destructive features and enhancements for more efficient and accurate image editing. This inspector provides instant access to the most critical and frequently used filters, enabling you to see results in real time and in context of one or more effects. Filters can be applied to an entire image or to specific parts of an image by the use of masks. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial. I can open the Adjustments Inspector by choosing Window, Inspectors, Adjustments, or I can click the three-dot icon below the list of open inspectors. This inspector centralizes several adjustment tools that in previous versions were available in separate dialogues, some of which were quite large and took up valuable workspace. From the available filters, Histogram, Light, and White Balance are displayed by default, and Histogram, with its auto-adjust feature, cannot be removed. I can add more filters by clicking the Add Adjustment icon, and I'll add Tone Curve and Hue Saturation Lightness. If I don't need the light adjustment, I can click its Options icon to remove it from the inspector. The Add menu also has a Show by Default option, where I can set the filters I want to appear by default. To give this forest photo a brighter appearance, I'll open White Balance, reduce the temperature, and increase tint and saturation. To see the filter effect, I can toggle it on and off. To start over, I can click the Reset icon or click the Options icon and choose Reset. Another popular filter is HSL. Using the Master Channel, I can change the overall hue of the image, decrease the saturation to wash out the color a bit, and darken it by reducing the lightness. I can combine this filter with Tone Curve to heighten the sunlight effect through the trees. Either effect can be toggled on and off, so I'll turn off Tone Curve and see if I like results better from the light filter. Now I can keep HSL on and compare between light and tone curve. For any set of effects, I can use the Auto Adjust Histogram feature. These effects can also be seen on the Effects tab, where I can toggle them on and off, change effect order, or edit an effect. A selected effect can be removed with the delete icon, and I can find more adjustment filters by clicking the plus icon, then opening the adjust menu. The previous example demonstrated how filters can be applied to an entire image, and it's also possible to apply filters to part of an image. For this photo, I can apply a contrast enhancement filter to the whole image, sampling a shadow color and a highlight color. But if I want to apply the filter only to the subject, I'll click the Options icon for the effect and choose Local Adjustment Mode. This activates my most recently used mask tool, in this case Brush Mask, and adds a mask that includes the entire image. I'll add some feathering to the brush, set the mask to Normal Mode, adjust the brush size while holding the Alt key and dragging the mouse, and paint the filter where I want. Now I'll turn off the Mask Marquee. The difference seems subtle, but toggling the effect on and off shows that the filter makes the subject really pop. I can also begin an effect in local adjustment mode. I'll add a gamma filter, command-click in the on-off box to switch to local adjustment, adjust the value, and paint in the effect. Any mask tool can be used for a local adjustment. In my last example, I want to transform this bright and colorful photo of a castle into something darker and more foreboding. I'll add a vibrance filter to wash out the entire image. Rather than keeping the filter on the entire image, I'll choose local adjustment mode, switch to the smart selection mask in normal mode, trace inside what I want to include, which is the castle and grounds, and use additive mode to include any pixels that were left out. I can further refine the mask borders around the spires by choosing Mask, Apply Smart Selection to Mask. Now I want to add a tone curve to the pixels of the sky. I can reuse the mask from the previous effect rather than having to go through the process of masking the sky. To do this, I'll open the Vibrance options and choose Create Mask from Adjustment. Now I'll choose Mask, Invert Mask so that only the sky is included, and start on the tone curve. I'll apply the effect to the mask, which changes just the sky. For the final touch, I'll auto-adjust. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on adjustments in PHOTO-PAINT. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial.